Hi, my name is Jeremy Farrell. I'm the manager of standard product engineering here at VPT. Today I'm going to be discussing the effects of high source impedance on our DC to DC converters, and I'm going to take some scope waveforms to show the effects of this high source impedance. For this demonstration, I'm going to use a DVTR 5 volt single, a standard benchtop power supply. This is going to measure VIN, VOUT, and also the scope is going to measure VIN and VOUT. I've added a 1 ohm resistor on the input to simulate a high source impedance. So if you look at the scope, the green trace is VIN, the yellow trace is VOUT. As VIN approaches the under voltage lockout point, it will start to oscillate. This oscillation is caused from the voltage drop across the 1 ohm resistor that is used to simulate the high source impedance. Here, the input voltage on the DC meter measures 16 volts. The output measures 1.5. However, when you look at the scope, the input voltage at the pins is actually dropping down to 11.1 volt, which causes the converter to turn back off. If you keep increasing VIN, eventually VIN will be high enough that voltage drop, the minimum point will be above the under voltage lockout point, and VOUT will come into regulation. As you can see from this demonstration, the source impedance does have an effect on the operation of our DC to DC converters. Care should be taken to minimize the source impedance, whether it be by shorting out any kind of resistors you have on the input to limit inrush, or the output impedance of whatever source you're using to drive our DC to DC converters. Thank you.